Assalamu alaikum and welcome all. Today we are having a still life drawing. This is a technique in which non-living objects are being drawn with the help of a background. So let's start our work. I have done the border. Okay, now I'll start making the shape of the curtain, leaving a few area, and I'm starting from the top and I'm going to make a shape of curtain like this, and then the other side also leaving a little bit gap. I'm just having the shape of the curtain. Now after this, from here I have to extend it down one, and then I'll the same way I have to extend it the other side. This much is done. Now I'll take my scale and I'll draw a line from 0 till 9 centimeter from the middle of the curtain. Horizontal line from 0 till 9 centimeter. Now the same way I'll just make it a double, 0 till 9. Now I'll just come to the standing position. For the standing position I have to have a line which is from 0 till 8.5 centimeter, like this. Again I'm making a double line, leaving some gap, 0 to 8.5. It's done. For the lamp, I'll just make the top part, okay, the top one, which is a curved one here, and then starting from one of this curved corner, I'll just extend that line, okay, making a shape of a pistil of a flower like this. Now I'll take a scale, leaving a little bit gap. Okay, I'll draw a line of 2 centimeter here from sleeping line from 0 to 2 centimeter, like this. Okay, and after this I'll just extend it from here with the free hand, 1-2 corners, just make a slant, then come down straight here, also a little slant and come down straight. And then again same thing, I have to repeat it here like this, come down, then move it, then go up, slant, reverse slant, come down and do it like this. I have done with this patch. Now I'll just take again my scale, I'll draw a line from here, leaving a little bit gap here, okay, as well as here. Okay, now after this what I have to do, under this I have to make the shape of the lamp, okay, the lower part of the lamp. So for that I have to just extend this line little bit down like this. I have to have a little slanting and then I just move it, curve it, and then come down here, and then the other way, other side also, I'll repeat the same thing, I'll just move it here. I should be careful that I should not be pointed. Okay, it should be little curved like this. Okay, now with this I have done the shape, lower part of the lamp. Okay, now close this part like this, then just take a scale, draw a line here, 1-2, okay, and then I'm going to extend it slanting way and then close it, the shape of the lower base of a lamp like this. See, I have done this much. Now I'll just close it, I'll just make a sleeping line, horizontal line here, okay, and I'll just make a little bit pattern like this and a slanting like this. Now your next step is make a line from here, curve line, the other corner, then here on the top also the bottom part, and then this middle line from a little bit up, you have to make one more, and then here also you have to have one more. I'm not going in detail right now because this detailing I'll do it towards the end of the drawing. Okay, now once I finish with the lamp, okay, I'll come to the bottom of this curtain, which I'm going to close it. like this. I have done with the bottom part of it. Now the next step is I have to make the loop, okay, for the curtain. I have to make a loop like this. I'm just extending from one corner of the lap to the other one like this. I'm just extending, okay, the same way both the sides. Now to make a loop here, I have to have a shape, a loop shape. I'll just erase this line, making a double line like this, one, and then I'm just going to extend the thread here, this side, and the same way I have to extend it the other way. Just erase the center one. Now after completing the curtain and the lamp, I'll just take my scale. I'll just divide, okay, the background and the lower part like this with a horizontal line. Completing it like this, just a light sketch. Okay, now I just have to have a glass. So glass, I'm going to have it here, which is on the floor. So for the glass also the same thing, I have to make the base, the top part of the glass. This is done. Okay, now I'm going to extend from one corner and the other corner like this. I have to just a little careful because it's a slanting and curve, both lines. So you also have to have slanting as well as curve like this. Now I'll complete the glass by joining the corners like this and making the base. This base is done. Okay, the detailing part I'll have it later on, so leave the detail as I'm telling you. So leave the detail, just I'm making the center like this. This glass is done. Now there is one more jar which I'm going to have it here. So the same way, I have to have the top part of the jar like this, make it a double. Okay, now we have to just start from one corner, just extended line slanting, and here also a slanting. After this you have to join this line, the two corners, and then I'm going to start from one corner making a curved line like this. The same way I'll repeat the other side also, making a curved line like this. Okay, after doing this curve, okay, I have to close the end, and you have to make sure that both the sides should have a proper curve. If it is not, just erase it and then do it like this, close the end. Now I erase the center line, this leaping which is coming inside the pot. See, I have erased it. Now I make the pattern, okay, curve pattern, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll just make a line, 1, 2, 3. Now like this we have done with the drawing, the pot, glass, lamp, curtain and the window. Okay, now I'll tell you how you have to use watercolor pencils. I'm starting from a yellow color watercolor pencil. I'm just coloring it, the frame of the window, yellow. Okay, after yellow on the frame, I'll just add a little bit orange color as well to give the effect of a darker as well as lighter tone. See, as you already know that you have to color it dark because these are watercolor pencils, they might get lighter in shade when you apply water. See, I have done with this. I'll take this orange color. I just add a little bit orange color in it. Okay, to just give a shade. When I'll just apply water with the help of a brush, this shade will come in yellow color. See, I have done. Okay, now I'll take this orange, light, dark, and peach color, these three colors for the curtain. I'm starting from the darker shade and I'm going to outline it first like this. Just half the color, a darker shade, orange color, color in one direction. Okay, in this I'm going to have the shading of light orange as well as peach also. I've done with orange part. I'm just leaving a little gap, okay, because this gap I'm going to fill with the peach color. See, it should be like this. See the gap which I'm leaving it here, that I'm going to fill it with the peach color like this. So in that way we are using basically three colors for the curtain: peach, light orange as well as dark orange to give the tones. I have done it here like this. Now I'm just having the same orange color. Okay, continue with the orange color, darker shade, corners you have to be careful. Okay, now I just have little orange shade as well. I have done with orange. Now I'm taking a light brown and golden color, okay, for the base of the drawing. Okay, I'm having a darker brown, light brown, sorry, golden brown first. Now I'm using a brown and yellow color. Okay, for the lamp base I'll start with yellow. I'll just half yellow color on few areas like this. I'll just color yellow. I'll just try to finish my yellow color first. Okay, now I'll add my brown color. When I'm just doing this, okay, I have done this yellow because I wanted to give a shade, okay, lighter and darker, and that's why I have added yellow, and I'm using a brown color for the rest all base of the lamp. I have done green here and gray here. Now I'm taking orange, light orange and brown color, and I'm coming to the top part of the lamp. Okay, I'm just coloring it like this. The orange one, lighter shade, to give just this shade. Okay, after this orange color, I will use the brown shade in this, like I have done it. Okay, see, I have done with this a little light shading. I'm taking this brown color. I'm just having towards the corner first, just outlining it like this, and then I'll just have it here in a curve shape like this. Just out darker this part wherever I'm using a dark brown color like this, and then towards the corner, this corner. Now rest all I have to have this orange color. Just go ahead. Okay, have a little shade of yellow because as if this lamp is on, so it should be little or yellowish, and then have a complete color orange. I have this added this brown shade as like this. Just give left one more shade of brown, okay, to have a final look like this. Okay, now after this I'll just take a brown, the same brown color, and I'll go ahead with the knot of the curtain. I'm going to color it brown, darker shade. Just color it dark here as well as this corner, the other side. Just color it with the dark brown tone Now color the loop as well, the same way the bow, the knot which you have done it. Okay, just color the same brown, darker shade, and I'm going to complete it like this. Here also I have to apply water with the help of a brush, so you have to use a thin brush and receive here. I have finished with this. Now I'll take a blue shade, lighter shade. I'll start for the window, the top part of the window, little light blue color, like this, just a little shade. After doing this, I'll just leave here. Okay, I'll take my dark blue color and I'll add here darker shade of blue towards the bottom. Okay, just a darker blue shade like this. Only towards the bottom, and just a little bit random towards the top also. Okay, see, I have done it like this. It's done. Now I'm taking a gray color and a white shade for the glass. I'll start for the with the gray color. Just have a gray color like this. Okay, the center will be, I'll just color it like this. So rest all will be whiter shade. Just I have to complete with the white shade. Now after completing this glass, this much just fine. I'll come to the jar. I'll just take this brown shade and just do it for the center one, a lighter shade. Then I'll take my yellow color. I'll just complete the base. Okay, here with the yellow color. Then I take a purple shade and I'm going to have it here. First outline this area, the neck part of the jar. Okay, and then I'm going to shade only the corners, one corner like this and the other corner you have to shade. Okay, leaving the center white. I have to complete it like this. See, leaving the center white. After this, I'll just take my green color. Okay, this shade, I'm going to complete the outline of the jar, the next part here like this. I have to complete the curves outline as well, as so that there should be no mistakes and the color should not go outside. Here also the same way, I have to have the shading. Okay, few areas I'm just having it dark, some sides, one side, and then the other side I'm just having it a light shade, just like this. I have done it, the neck part as well as the other side. This is done. Now I'll take a pink shade, a lighter shade pink, and I'll come towards the other part of the jar, making these lines first. Okay, it's done. Now I'll just color it. I'll take my brush, a thin one, okay, and a water. I'll just dip in water and I'll start applying the water, but I have applied very less. Be very careful, start from a lighter shade, okay, because it is easy. See, I have to start from here like this. I have started the water coloring here. The same way I have to complete for the full drawing. Always, whenever you start applying the water, just be careful. You have to apply from the lighter shade, and after completing one color, just try to clean your brush, okay, and then you can use it for the second color. Otherwise you can go to the darker tone. Okay, the same darker tone, you can go ahead. I'm using the same brush because the upper part was lighter shade, and here I'm using a darker one. This is the final image of the picture. This is how we have to complete. And after completing the watercolor, I have applied black color outline for the curtain and everything, all the objects, whatever is here. And I have done orange color border outline as well as. So here we have done with watercolor activity. Hope you like it and love doing it. Thank you. See you inshallah in the next activity.